So, you hate Ticketmaster, you don't want to support them anymore, you want to make sure that your tickets can still get sold, but you don't want to use their terrible, terrible platform, so you have to go somewhere else. Let's try StubHub. What's up, guys? Welcome back. My name's Shiraz here on Thumbs Up Run, where we talk about buying tickets, selling tickets, and making sure that you have all the fun with your tickets. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, clicking that little subscribe button and the little bell icon below to make sure that you never miss out on any of my weekly ticket updates that are coming out all the time. So today, I want to talk about listing tickets on StubHub specifically, as well as discussing a few things you need to remember when you are listing your tickets elsewhere outside of the Ticketmaster platform. Enough preamble. Let's get into it. All right, so first off, if you're going to be listing tickets on StubHub, there's a few things that you do need to remember before you get started. Three main things. First one, you have to make sure that you have tickets available to sell. What I'm basically trying to say is that don't be listing speculative tickets. You have to make sure that the tickets you're listing are ones that you actually have already purchased and bought. You may not have them in your possession just this second, but if you've already gone ahead, purchased the tickets, you know they're gonna get to you at some point in the future before they actually need to be delivered, then by all means, go ahead, list those tickets. Don't be doing what people do in this video up here where they're selling speculative tickets, trying to prey on those who are trying to buy tickets immediately when they're not even ready from the box office. Number two, the next thing is making sure you have tickets that are transferable. What does that mean? Basically, some ticket types, they're not able to be transferred to another person. Something such as will call tickets, these ones, they're generally tied to a specific account holder, account name, a specific purchaser who wanted to buy those tickets. And unfortunately on StubHub, they do not allow this type of ticket sale. However, there are a few couple of exceptions where this may not be the case, but for the most part, most people will not be able to get access to sell tickets through will call on StubHub. So the only types of tickets that can be sold on StubHub are transferable versions. Hard tickets are fine, PDF tickets are fine, mobile screenshots, for the most part are fine, but always double check. Mobile transfer tickets, as long as the transfer feature is enabled, that's fine as well. And lastly, number three, you have to make sure that you have an eligible event. On StubHub and various other resale marketplaces, they do not allow certain type of charity or benefit type events being listed on their platform. So there are various charity type events that StubHub will just not allow to be listed. As well, there are certain performers and artists and venues that also don't allow tickets to be resold. So someone such as Louis CK, he doesn't allow tickets being sold on StubHub at all. UFC, they have specific restrictions on what dates you're allowed to actually have tickets go up live on sale on StubHub. So again, keep that one in mind. There's a whole bunch of them. And then there's various one-off events that are just not allowed to be resold on StubHub. I'll put a link in the description below that has a list of all the various events that are currently not available to be sold on StubHub, and this list is always changing, constantly evolving and getting larger and smaller as events take place and are eventually removed from the list. With all of that though, it does mean everything else, you're good to go. We're ready to go sell things. Let's dive into it. All right, so today we're gonna be using the StubHub app to actually list our tickets. This can also be done on the computer very, very simply. First off, if you wanna sell an event on StubHub, you have two avenues of doing this. There's actually a sell button on the bottom down here that you can go ahead and click, type in the artist, venue, name, details of the event itself. Go ahead, find the event that way. The other way is actually if you found the event on StubHub, you can go ahead, sell it directly from the event. All right, so very simply, there are just a couple of things you need to make sure you follow, and they make this very straightforward when selling it, especially through the app and even on the website. Step one, delivery. Tell us what kind of tickets you're selling and how you're going to be able to deliver them. So go ahead, hit the little edit button, and you have a few options. So each event will have a different set of delivery options. Some events will allow you to sell PDF tickets, some events will allow you to sell mobile tickets, and others will allow you to actually sell hard tickets themselves too. You know, physical cardstock tickets, the good stuff. Now, regardless of the type of option you select, they're all valid ticket options. Only thing you have to remember is that if you list it as a hard ticket, then the tickets need to actually be physically shipped in time for the buyer to be able to get to the event on time. Otherwise, for PDF tickets, mobile tickets, some of these, they can be set up as instant delivery so that it doesn't matter what time they actually goes ahead and makes that purchase. They'll be able to get those tickets very, very fast, almost immediately in some cases. If you look at mobile tickets there, the only difference between mobile transfer and mobile tickets is that one is the screenshot version. Now with screenshots, it's important to know if the event is considered safe ticks or not. With Ticketmaster, they have introduced something called safe ticks. They're basically rotating barcode tickets, basically meaning you cannot actually take a screenshot of those barcodes. Many events are still not yet having this feature incorporated, so you're fine to go ahead, for the most part, send screenshot tickets. If they are safe tickets, you will know. It'll be very, very apparent. You can't go ahead and use screenshots, but again, mobile transfer always fun. So for me, I have some mobile transfer tickets available here. So I'm gonna go ahead and select mobile transfer. And now we have to say, when will these tickets be able to be delivered? You can either say, yes, I'm ready to transfer them right now. I have them in my possession. I can go ahead, just send them as soon as they get sold. Or I can select the other option. So the other option though, the date option, it will default to the last possible date you'll be able to transfer those tickets. This doesn't mean that you must wait until that date to actually go ahead and transfer tickets once your tickets sell. You can do it before then. It's just saying, hey, by the way, this is the last day you can do it. So if you guarantee that you're gonna get these tickets in time, oh, by all means, go ahead, take all the time you need to make sure these tickets get to the seller. Best case is always to give yourself as much time as possible. Go ahead, say, oh no, I'll deliver them by February 17th in this case, regardless of whether I actually have them in my possession yet or not. I know that if they did sell today, I would be able to transfer them immediately, and that's fine. But for the most part, why would I try and limit myself just in case, you know, something comes up, I'm not able to get to my computer in time, get to my phone in time. I give myself a few extra days to go ahead and make that transfer. From the buyer's perspective, they'll say, oh, okay, it's coming February 17th. But again, all tickets are guaranteed to be delivered on time before the event actually takes place. So it's not really an issue at all. And as you can see, as we move through these steps, green check marks start to appear. Fantastic. So we're gonna move on to step two, the details, talking about the tickets themselves, number of tickets we have, yada, yada, yada. So first off, we see we have a few options. We can go with general admission or not. This event I know is not general admission, but if it were, it basically gives you a description of what that means. You'll know the tickets themselves, they will state specifically if they are general admission or not. The seats we have are in section 108. Now, as you start typing, they will be able to actually map directly to where the seats are actually supposed to be. So in this case, I have a few options. I know that my seats are on the glass, so we're gonna go lower level and glass 108. Row is row A. I know this because that's what they are. And now the next option is seat. So seat is interesting. When you list tickets on Ticketmaster, the seat numbers themselves, they are automatically assigned and put into the sale once you've actually listed those tickets. On StubHub and other resale marketplaces, however, you do not require the seat numbers. Reason behind that is to protect the actual sellers themselves. So there are various times where when a seller is going to go ahead and list a bunch of tickets, say they're an actual professional reseller, they don't want different events and venues and teams to actually start canceling their seats. So what they're gonna do, they're actually gonna mask their seat numbers. It doesn't mean that the seats are not real, doesn't mean the seats don't exist, doesn't mean the seats aren't there, it just means that they're trying to protect themselves. All that being said, you are not required to put in the seat numbers. In this case, I know what my seat numbers are. They are 5 and 6, but we're not gonna be putting them in because we don't need to. It doesn't matter. Some buyers, they do like to know where their seats are gonna be located exactly. And if that's the case, usually Ticketmaster is the place for you to start looking because everything is assigned to a specific seat location. If you're going through another resale marketplace, not all of them will have their tickets listed with seat numbers. Some of them will, some of them won't. When they're instant delivery, generally they'll be listed, but not always the case. The last thing here at the bottom, my tickets have unique ticket numbers. Don't need to worry about that at all. Just continue going forward. I'm finding that there's it's a bit finicky. The seat, it wouldn't let me hit the next button until I had a seat number assigned. However, like I said, not required. So I went ahead, deleted them. I now see 2 seats. I'm gonna go hit next. All right, next section is talking about features. So features here, these are just anything that you wanna say that makes that seat more unique, more special, more valuable. Sometimes it's as simple as just saying the seats are on the aisle. You can also say that there's a parking pass included or whatever other features that are identified within the features list. Again, these are optional, not required. So if you don't see anything here that applies to your ticket, just go ahead, hit next. Next thing off, are there any disclosures? So this is not the same as features. Features are anything that are positive, generally speaking, about this section or the seats that you've listed. Disclosures are things that are, generally speaking, more negative. A lot of times disclosure is something to say these seats are not a full view seat. They're either a side view seat, limited view seat, behind the stage seat for concerts. Usually there's some kind of negative connotation with it, but it needs to be stated because these seats have some kind of disclosure written on them specifically. If you're ever unsure if there is a disclosure on your seat, go back to the box office, go back to where your ticket order was actually done. You will normally find any type of disclosures that need to be made on that page. In this case, there are no disclosures, there's no restrictions or limitations that I need to put on, but again, let's just dive into these very quickly. So a lot of times the restrictions, there could be something to do with age, it could be wheelchair accessible seats only. Again, if there are no restrictions, just go ahead, click no restrictions. Same thing, let's jump over to the limitation side. So again, these are more on the obstructed view type seating options. Go ahead, just scroll through them all, see if any of them actually apply. Usually the most common one will be something like partial view, limited or obstructed view, side view, something like that. These disclosures, these limitations, they're usually listed on the ticket itself, so they're very easy to identify and be able to put in the proper description. If you do not put the limitations and disclosures in this section when you're actually going to head to list and then the tickets end up selling, if the buyer realizes after the fact that these tickets were in a limited view section or partial view section and the disclosure wasn't there, they're gonna come after you. You're gonna be hit with penalties. It can become a big problem. So make sure that you take the time to list your tickets properly, list all the disclosures, limitations as they're stated on the ticket to make sure that you don't get hit with any type of penalties in the future. In this case, there are no limitations for my tickets, so I'm gonna go ahead and hit no limitations. We're now off to the next section. We're going into pricing. Fantastic. Depending on the location of where you're listing your tickets, where the event is actually taking place, you may or may not be required to put in the face value of the seats. Now, if you cannot find the face value anywhere, you're not sure how much the face value is, go ahead, put your best estimate. I don't have it on hand, so I'm just gonna say the face value is $200. StubHub then, when you get to the pricing page, will actually go ahead and give you a recommended price to list the tickets at. So as you can see here, it's listed them already at $83, and it's giving you a breakout of what your estimated payout will be based on the final sale price that you've set. You know, you'll see that there is the service fees and taxes and things that are gonna deduct from your take-home pay, but it'll give you an estimated payout of what you're gonna make total. Down here, you can go ahead on the bottom, there's a slider that where you can go ahead, adjust the ticket price to where you think it'll be best suited. So you don't actually have to take what StubHub is giving you as the recommended number. So StubHub, they're always gonna try and give you a recommended price, try and keep you within a specific range, because obviously from their point of view, if you sell your tickets, they're gonna get paid as well. So it's in their best interest for you to list your tickets as cheap as possible. Now, if you wanna actually take a look at what the map view looks like, you can go ahead and do that. See what seats are selling for. You can go ahead, you know, zoom in. So if I hit these three little ellipsis dots, I can hit zone. It'll give me the list of all the other seats in that same type of section throughout the rest of the map. So I know with the lower level and glass, that's still the cheapest option, the other one that's in that section. And if I click the other type of glass seats, I can see that there's a few other options. So in the club glass seats, they've gone down to $163.67. So again, I could potentially lower my price even further to try and compete with that. Once I'm done looking at the map, I can go ahead and hit the X, jump back, and kind of make my final decision. If I want to put an exact number myself, I can go ahead, just type it in. Let's say I'm going to put them for $241.73. Fantastic. So last step here is the payout side. So you actually have to set up how you're going to get paid. So whether that's through PayPal or direct deposit, you can go ahead, go through all those steps inside of there. As well, you actually have to tie a credit card to your account. Now, the reason you have to tie the credit card is because in case there are any type of issues with those tickets when you've actually delivered them. Sometimes it could be that you didn't put the right listings or the disclosure on the ticket, so then there's gonna be some kind of penalty. StubHub needs to be able to actually make sure they can charge you immediately to make sure that they cover all of these replacement type of costs and fees. Now, if you wanna go ahead and start editing your listing, maybe you didn't price it quite right, you wanna just make sure everything is good to go, you can go ahead into the StubHub app, go into the computer, check there, go to your My Listings page. You can see all the details right there on the main page. If you wanna adjust the price, simply just tap on the price itself, go ahead, make any changes that you desire, and then just basically hit save. This case, I think I'm going to leave it as is, so nothing to do there. Now I don't wanna sell them anymore. I can go ahead and hit either deactivate or delete. If I hit deactivate, the listing itself will just take itself off StubHub, but the listing will still be there in the background in my deactivated tab. The reason someone might wanna do this is because you might just wanna put it on hold saying, hey, I'm not sure, I may or may not want these tickets myself, or I may have found someone else I can sell them to. And so you aren't sure if you wanna just delete all that information from having to re-input it over and over again on StubHub. If, however, you decide that you no longer wanna have any information listed on StubHub, go ahead, delete the entire listing, just hit the delete button, poof, gone. Don't see anything there anymore. Tickets cannot be sold on StubHub. You have nothing to worry about. Now, on the computer itself, there are a few additional features that are available to you, such as the ability to, you know, check out some of the sold inventory pricing. Kind of gives you a better idea of what people are actually spending so that you can go ahead, try and price a bit more aggressively and get yourself to that sold ticket stage. Fantastic. When you're on StubHub, if the tickets are not set up to be instant delivery, such as, you know, PDF tickets that have already been uploaded or screenshot tickets which have already been uploaded as well, then you actually have to go through the whole transfer process. So what does that mean? If you have, for example, hard stock tickets, you actually have to go and ship them through UPS. StubHub will send you a shipping label once the tickets actually sell. Go ahead, print that off, bring that with the tickets to a UPS location. They'll go ahead, get you set up with the envelope, make sure everything gets put in correctly, send it off, nothing further to do. If you have mobile tickets, it's important that you go back to where you purchased those tickets from originally, go through the ticket transfer process. There will obviously be instructions there on how to do so. Make sure you have the right email that is given from StubHub to transfer the tickets to. Go ahead, do that, and then once you're done that, just make sure you mark it as complete as transferred so that you can go ahead and get paid. One other thing I did not mention is that when you're selling tickets on StubHub, the actual seller fee that you're paying to get your tickets listed can range widely. It can range from as little as 10%, as high as 15%. It really depends on the event itself. Each event is different, and then also the amount of volume that you sell through StubHub. So if you do start hitting some of those metrics, you are able to actually reduce your seller fees little by little. But for the most part, most sellers, they're just gonna be stuck at the standard 10 to 15% rate. Overall though, I would say it's a very intuitive, very, very easy way to go ahead and list your tickets. Only other thing I would say is that be very, very careful if you're gonna be listing tickets on other resale platforms as well. I will dive into this a bit later in the future, talking about listing tickets on multiple platforms, but the key takeaway here is that if you list them on one platform, make sure that you're also being very careful if they're listed on another platform. You don't want to have the situation where they end up selling twice, and then you're gonna have a lot of problems trying to figure out how to actually manage this situation. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I think there was a lot of good content in here. Let me know in the comments below what you guys thought. Let me know if you have any other questions. First few times you go through this process might be a bit confusing, might be a bit intimidating, but after you kind of get used to it, understanding some of the selling features that are available through StubHub as well, you might even be able to start leveraging some of these features and being able to use it to help you price things better when you're listing things on Ticketmaster or other resale marketplaces. If you haven't subscribed, just go ahead and do that right now. New videos coming up every single week. So again, you'll be getting your full content load of all things tickets related. Thanks again for watching, and see you guys next time.